You're a Massachusetts general, baby.
Mm-hmm. I was, actually, I think I was born in Boston, Lying In, it was called in those days, and it may have morphed to Brigham and Women's in this day, but my dad was at Mass General and Boston City Hospital when he was doing his internship and residency. So we lived here, I was born here, and we lived here until, I think, 51, and then we moved down to Chapel Hill,
where you went to school. That's right. So little would you know that many years later, flash forward to 6 weeks ago, that those hospitals and amazing doctors and nurses and staff treated so many people who survived the bombings, and you're here for the concert. How do you feel with all these bands coming together for such a big night?
You know, I think it's the way we respond. I think Don Law, who's sort of a fixture, an institution here in Boston, Boston is his turf, and you know, Don called and said that he was putting together a concert. Was I interested in playing? I said sure, and I'm sure that you know, I was talking to Jimmy Buffett earlier, and he said, you know, Boston's been good to me, and I didn't hesitate, and I'm sure that that's the way everybody who's on the bill tonight responded, you know, just...
no hesitation, yes.
Absolutely, yeah. And, you know, the other thing is that you were mentioning the hospitals and the all the first mm-hmm. responders and the community really... Everybody in Boston just feels so bad about what happened, and so concerned, and so, you know, just like you get the feeling that anybody that you asked would do whatever they could to try to help the people who were injured, and to try to sort of heal, try to help heal heal the town after this and the area. Boston's so special, and the marathon too. So.
Quintessential Boston experience, right?
It really is.
Sox game during the day, come to the finish line.
That's right, and it's such an inclusive and you know, sort of global event. It seems just, you know, how you could possibly want to target the Boston Marathon, you know, where we cheer the plucky Kenyan who overcomes the stacked deck of life and makes it over the finish line, or Grandpa has just made it through chemo and he's back on the in his running shoes again, or you know, parents watching their children finish, or children watching their parents finish. It's just really was the most inappropriate and really unfathomable kind of thing, just so wrong.